Welcome, everybody. My name is Dr. Peter Green. I'm the Chair of Visual and Performing Arts at Glendale College. We are the GCC Concert Singers. The second piece we're about to hear is by Richard Burchard. He's an Associate Professor of Music at Bellarmine University in Louisville, Kentucky. O Vos Omnes was originally sung as a part of the Roman Catholic liturgy, often sung as a motet. The text is from the Book of Lamentations. We hope you enjoy.
Silence is a poem by Robert Bodie. The words are simple, yet have profound depth. Give me this life that I may hear you, blessed world, that I may hear the snow as it kisses the earth. It seems to be a plea to escape the chaos and busyness of day-to-day life and find peace. The composer, Jacob Narvarud, does a lovely job shaping this piece. The piano introduction even sounds like gently falling snow. The song swells with the words of the poem and then retreats to simplicity once more. Next is one of my personal favorites, Let My Love Be Heard. It is composed by the award-winning Jacob Runstad. The lyrics of this contemporary piece come from a poem entitled A Prayer, written by Alfred Noyes, who was born in 1880. The speaker addresses the angels, seemingly requesting they carry his prayers and love to God. Fittingly, this song is filled with ethereal chords to assist in painting the aural picture. GCC Concert Singers would like to dedicate this song to the Oakland fire victims. We hope you enjoy this piece as much as we do.
The next two pieces will feature our men and our women independently. The women's piece, Et Misericordia, written by the young Norwegian composer Kim Andre Arneson in 2010, is part of a larger work entitled The Magnificat. The Magnificat is the Virgin Mary's song of praise to God after one of the Bible's greatest wonders, the angel Gabriel visiting her with a message that she is to be the mother of God's Son. In his setting, Kim Andre Arneson expresses the feelings Mary must have felt: wonder, devotion, gratitude, joy, humility, hope, and compassion. Arneson sees the Magnificat as offering support and hope for all people struggling against adversity or in need of strength. The text of the piece is from the Bible verse Luke chapter 1, verse 50. Et misericordia eos et progenies, in progenies timetibus eum, and his mercy is on them that fear him from generation to generation. The men's piece, We Rise Again, was written by Leon Dubinsky, a songwriter from Sydney, Nova Scotia, for a 1984 stage musical titled The Rise and Follies of Cape Breton. As an anthem of resilience and hope at a time when Cape Breton Island was going through an economic crisis. According to Dubinsky, the song is about the cycles of immigration, the economic insecurity of living in Cape Breton, the power of the ocean, the meaning of children, and the strength of home given to us by our families, our friends, and our music.
Misericordia, or through my lungs, let misericordia.
These next two songs are composed by William Malpede, a local composer from Los Angeles, and are both poem adaptations. The first song, Rio de Rosas, which translates to River of Roses, was written by Ricardo Garcia. In the words of Malpede, the music reflects a simplicity with just a touch of Mexican folk music flavor in some of the harmony and the 3/4 time. We reach a more dramatic and angelic conclusion in the last spiritual line of this piece. The beautiful imagery of the poem is an allegory for life. We walk alongside and amongst the roses as our faith leads the way. The following song, Sound Over All Waters, is adapted from the poem A Christmas Carmen by American author John Greenleaf Whittier. This piece employs some contemporary popular dance rhythms, especially through a syncopation, and conveys a mysterious, somewhat ethereal quality. It tells the coming of Christ as a time heralding the clasping of hands, the end of the dark night, and the long quarrel ceasing. We hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
in the back row, we have the lyricist Rick and the composer Billy. Everybody. So the next couple of pieces that we're going to do are arrangements of Filipino folk songs. When I chose the music, I thought it would be exciting for us to ask a traditional Filipino dance group to join us in one of the songs. It made it easier that I'm friends with these four people that are dancing today. The special guests joining us today are Kayamanan Ng Lahi. They are a critically acclaimed nonprofit Filipino traditional dance group based here in LA. Traditional folk song Rosas Pandan is a song of joy and love. George Hernandez, who's the conductor of the Sarang Himig Singers from San Francisco, has captured the native Visayan flavor in this playful arrangement. After Rosas Pandan, we have a special treat for you from Kayamanan, and then after that, we will sing Himig Pasko. Himig Pasko is a traditional Christmas carol from the Philippines. So we're going to start today with Rosas Pandan and Kayamanan Ng Lahi. Robert, Jed, Tricia, and Tanette for dancing for us.
Well, first I'd like to thank Dr. Peter Green for inviting our group and the Glendale Community College Singers. They're great, aren't they? I'm a little short, so I'm going to stand up here real quick. So just a little bit about our group, Kayamanan Ng Lahi, which means treasures of our people. And this year we're celebrating our 26th anniversary. And basically, what we're here to do is to present, promote, and preserve our Philippine arts and culture through dance and music. So this was our first time dancing to a cappella choral music. And it's been a lot of fun, a little challenging, but a lot of fun. So we hope you enjoy. We have one more dance to go. With this one, we have a recorded track, and it's one of the more popular dances in the Philippines. It's called Tinikling. Basically, it's down from a province called Leyte, and it's about about the tickling birds. So the dancers represent the tickling birds, and they're kind of trying not to get caught in the traps in the rice terraces. So it's going to be, you'll see us dancing in the bamboos, trying not to get our feet caught. So we hope you enjoy.
The sopranos ask if they can dance, and I always tell them no. This is the first time we've ever had dancers at our program. Thank you.
So the song we just sang was a Christmas song, which leads us into the last section of this evening's program, which is called Sounds of the Season. The first song of this section is called While Shepherds Watched Their Flocks, composed by Craig Courtney. Courtney is a distinguished contemporary composer who has contributed to musical institutions such as the Mozarteum in Salzburg and has also served as a member of the music ministry of the Salzburg International Baptist Church. The second song we'll be singing is called On Christmas Night, All Christians Sing, which is in fact written by one of our very own choir members, Mr. David Layne. He has composed it for our choir to premiere to you all this evening, so we hope that you enjoy it. And the final piece for this evening's program is called A Musicological Journey Through the 12 Days of Christmas, which is also composed by Craig Courtney. It is a very exciting rendering of this traditional Christmas song, which most of us are familiar with. Each of the movements in increasing order follow a chronological trail through the different musical periods and the styles of composition which were typical of those periods. This means that you'll be hearing everything from Roman Gregorian chants to Wagner's Rite of the Valkyries. We hope you enjoy.
Oh, Thank you. great holiday season, and please join us over in the social hall. We have snacks and coffee and tea and stuff over there. You can come over and talk to us. Thank you, everybody.